Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making fancy wild rice. And we're doing it with a mix, so that makes it really convenient and easy. But we're adding some things in, so we're putting our own touch to it. We'll start out with the add-ons. We're going to be sauteing a couple of vegetables here in butter. So I have some salted butter, 1 tablespoon, which I have melted. And then what I'm going to add is 1 cup of mushrooms sliced. These are baby portobellos, and we have 1 cup there. I let it go a little above a cup because there are a lot of empty spaces in there, and it's hard to pack it in tightly when you have slices that large. So it doesn't have to be exact anyway. And there we go with our mushrooms. And then you need 3. Green onions, something like this. I've already got them sliced up. Just slice them and put them in. And then what we're going to do is move over to the stove and saute these until they are tender. And then we can continue with the recipe. So this is about the way your green onions and mushrooms will look when you have sauteed them. It doesn't take very long at all, probably 5 minutes or less. So I'm going to bring this back over to my workspace. And here's where the packaged rice comes in. And what I've chosen is Uncle Ben's long grain and wild rice fast cook recipe. It could be that you won't be able to find exactly this package, but you'll probably find something similar. If it does not say fast cook recipe, then just follow the instructions as far as how long it needs to be cooked. In this particular container, you will find rice, which is long grain and wild rice. So there are 2 kinds that are sort of mixed in here. I think 1 type first, so you'll probably see it as it's shaken out. And then the 2nd type comes later. You begin to see the brown ones coming. The wild rice is the brown rice. So there it is, all of it in there. And then there is a flavoring packet, which sometimes I use, sometimes I don't use, depending on my purpose for using the long grain and wild rice. But in this application, we're going to use the flavorings. There are some nice flavorings here. You can see that there is actually some powdered spice that goes into it, as well as some dried herbs. So there is this much of that in the packet, if I can possibly show you. It is quite a lot, maybe more than you would expect. So let me crumble that up a little bit and put all of that in. And then we've got our rice and our seasoning packet taken care of. So we'll put in the liquid. You need 2 cups of water. Just pour that in here. And then I need to put this back on the stove, and it needs to be covered. What I have decided to do is pour it into a saucepan because I have a better cover for this saucepan, and it will be kind of sealed, whereas lids that I have for a skillet like this would probably sink down in it and not be quite as good. Probably should have mixed it up in this other saucepan, but we'll just pour it and it will be fine. So all of that mixture put into a saucepan that you do have a lid that fits it. And once you get that done, place your lid on the top, take it back to the stove, bring it to a boil, and boil it for 10 minutes, and it will be done. It's that quick and easy, so I'll serve it up to you in 10 minutes. My 10-minute timer just went off, so I know it's time to take these off the stove. I'm turning this off and bringing this over to the counter. And right here we have our wild rice dish. Let me get rid of this lid. It's very hot, so I'm just going to stick it over here in the sink. And then I've got a little dish here ready to receive this, and I'll stir it up just a bit. You can let it sit and settle if you like, But this is a really nice combination with the mushrooms and the green onions, and then that packet of herbs and spices along with long grain and wild rice. So let me just place a little over here on our serving plate. And I have some tarragon at the edge just for some greenery. And I'd say that's more than one serving, but since I don't have a whole dinner that I'm displaying here, I'm just concentrating on showing you what the wild rice looks like. So this is the fancy wild rice.